In 1925, a paper published in Nature told the story of a curious fossil that had just been unearthed in South Africa. It would become our earliest piece of evidence of humanity's African origins. However, the paper was mocked by leading British anthropologists at the time. That's because in 1912, solicitor and part-time archaeologist Charles Dawson claimed to have discovered a skull in Sussex in England that he would name the Piltdown Man. And the British scientific establishment, well, they immediately fell in love and believed his finding. And there was a good reason for this. The skull aligned perfectly with scientific theories at the time that held that large brains that we see in humans evolved before human-like jaws did. And so Charles Dawson's findings quickly gained a reputation for being the missing link, as the Piltdown Man had a human-like cranium and an ape-like jaw. The British press quickly named the Piltdown Man as the earliest Englishman, while also comparing indigenous Australians and Africans to Piltdown to reinforce racial hierarchies. Despite being a forgery, the Piltdown skull quickly emerged as a nationalistic tool to bring ancient humans closer to the British while also dehumanizing other races. The forgery would only be uncovered in 1953 when it became clear that Dawson had combined an orangutan jaw with a modern human cranium and stained the specimen with a mixture of iron and chromium to give it an artificially aged appearance. It's thought that Charles Dawson had forged 37 of his other archaeological findings. Today we know that the 1925 specimen is a genuine fossil of the species Australopithecus africanus, and as it turns out, Darwin was correct all along, as he had predicted in his 1871 book, The Descent of Man, that the human lineage originates in Africa.